Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let me show you how to create circular text on your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 500 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So creating circular text on your Mac can be very frustrating if you don't have expensive Adobe apps. However, there are other apps that you could do it. The Mac App Store has several. One good option is to use Acorn, which is an image editing tool you may have already bought to use for other things. Acorn has a great circular text tool. And you could build circular text in Acorn and then export it to use elsewhere. So I'm using Acorn version 6.5.3. Make sure you're using that version or something newer. I got it in the Mac App Store. And I'm going to create a new document and set it to be something square. Let's do 800 by 800 transparent and hit OK. Then I'm going to expand the window here so I could see the drawing area clearly. And creating circle text is actually pretty easy. You've got a text tool here. Now you probably have it set to plain text like that. But if you click and hold this tool, you can select circle text or path text. So we'll select circle text. Then I'll click near the middle and it will create the circle and there'll be a text cursor at the top. And now I can simply just type. I'm going to use all caps because capital letters seem to work better around a circle. So you can see how it added the text here and kept it centered on the circle with the center being here at the top. I can select all, Command A, and I can change this text just like any other. So I can make it a larger size. I can left justify it instead of right justify it. So you can see it starts here at this dot. We have three control dots here. This dot is the rotation dot and it starts here. But if I do centered, then it's centered with that dot kind of being, think of that as the left side of the text box. Now this dot here you can click and drag and move that point so you can change where the text starts. This dot here you could change the size. And this dot here changes whether or not the text is on the outside of the circle or if you click it then the text is on the inside of the circle, which is going to come in handy here in a minute. But I'm going to use this text on the outside of the circle. Now I'm going to select the Move tool here and now I can drag this around. I'm going to make sure it's centered here on this document. And then I'm going to create another text circle. So I'm going to click there, click in the middle, and I'm going to type the text I want to be at the bottom. Now what I'm going to do here is I am going to click this black circle here to move that text into the inside. And then I'm going to click here and rotate this around to be 0 degrees. So this text is on the inside and at the bottom. Now I want to enlarge the circle because notice how with this text being on the inside and this being on the outside they don't line up. But if I use this dot here I can move the circle so it matches the top of the text here. And you could see now how it basically puts both pieces of text in the same circle. I can select all and let's increase the size of this text here at the bottom. And also I want to increase the kerning a bit just to move those letters across. Sometimes the letters get a little smooshed together because of it being on a circle. So increasing it just slightly like that can make a big difference. Let's just do it like 5. So now I've got something pretty much ready to use except that I really want to actually have a kind of circle background on this. So I'm going to select the circle shape here, click and drag to create a circle. I'm going to use the shift key to make sure it stays circular, not oval. And then I'm going to leave it there, switch to the move tool and center it right there. I did a pretty good job of guessing the outside of the circle here. Let me go and change the fill color. You can see it's, there's fill and I can click the color there. Make it completely opaque. Let's make it red for now. And then I'm going to go to shape and then arrange and send to back. So it'll be behind this text here. Then I'm going to duplicate it. So I'm going to do copy and paste. And I have this other circle here. I'm going to shrink this down. I could just grab the corner of it here. Actually, if you hold the shift key, it'll do a good job of keeping it in kind of the same ratio. I'm going to change the fill color of this to, let's say, black here. And then I'm going to move this into the center. And it's not quite the size I want. I'm going to continue to shrink it down and recenter it till I get about the size I want. So just a little bit more there. So that's good. That's what I want to cut out. Now I have that selected. I'm going to shift select the outer circle. So now I have both selected. I can tell because I could drag them both like that. Just undo to put them back. And then I'm going to do shape and then exclude paths, which will then cut a hole out in the middle. I need to reapply the color there and then move it back. So I'm going to do arrange, send to back. And now the red is behind there. Now I can do further adjustments. I can see that this text here seems to be pretty well centered, but this text at the bottom here, I'll click away and then click there. I need to maybe just enlarge that circle just a little bit to get it right there in the middle. And there we go. So now we've got some text that we could use. Since this is a transparent image, I can now go to File, Export, and do Export, and then do a PNG so it remains transparent, and save it out so I have a transparent image I can use in other apps. I could also just, of course, use this in Acorn. Be sure to save it as an Acorn document as well. So then you'll be able to open up the document again in Acorn and edit the text and other elements if you want. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.